Die herder. Ja, almost open there. This video is sponsored by World of Tanks. World of Tanks is free to play with over 100 million players worldwide and for PC. The game has more than 600 tanks. Destroyers, artillery, light, medium and heavy tanks, there is always a new way to play. You can roll out across open fields, climb steep hills, sneak through forests, tear across deserts and pick your battles in urban industrial zones. There are over 40 battle arenas to pick from. Historical accuracy and inspiration mean authentic models and vehicle characteristics that make you feel like a real tank commander. You can earn experience, modify and upgrade your tank to create a steel beast ready for any battle. Download World of Tanks by using the first link in the description. During registration, use the code TANKMANIA to get for free 7 days premium account, 250,000 credits, the premium tank Excelsior and 3 rental tanks for 10 battles each. Tiger 131, Cromwell B, and T-34-85M. Hi there, you're watching Metal Detecting World War II Battlegrounds, and this time I got invited by Ray from the Dutch Relic Diggers and the guys from World War II Artifacts. We're in a beautiful area right now. There's a lot of dugouts and trenches as well. And actually they have been here in the past and encountered a super big object, and they're actually already working to dig that out. So I'm gonna give them a hand. Let's see what we can discover here. And they already found some great stuff here in the past. So this should be a really fruitful area. As you can see, they're already at it. So yeah, without further ado, let's get our hands dirty. Right, let's make myself useful here. What is that, war related?
Yeah, I think so. Huh. The smoke channel.
Oh yeah. Right, so this object just came out and we think it's a chimney pipe. Maybe they had some stove here. I guess we're gonna find out. Right, we've been at it for like 15 minutes. First thing down there, some movement there. Let's see if we can get that out. Yes, our thoughts are confirmed. This is a stove indeed, I think. Top plate. They could have some pots boiling here, and given the size of that and the other stuff that's still in the ground, they could feed quite some men here. I think we have quite some work cut out for us here. Second piece here. Come out. Wow. Well, that's the other half of the stove. Yeah. And there it is, complete. Right, I think Ray just found a pan there. Just had a small heart attack there, I think. He told me he thought he found a helmet, but obviously it's not. But yeah, I mean, we are finding some more things besides this stove here, so that's a good sign. We got another massive thing right here, look at that. That might be the actual stove. Here, see this corner here? This is cast iron, I think. There, you can see this enameled white color, and this is all solid metal here, this corner. Really massive kettle down there, guys. Might take a while before we have it out. Well, my jacket's off. I'm so hot. Yeah, digging in these sorts of dugouts really gets your blood flowing, I can tell you that. See how deep that already is. Like 2 meters deep already, and the actual stove is still down there, so we are trying hard to dig that one out. But it's very loose sand, so it's quite difficult. The walls keep collapsing on us, so Okay, so Jeff just pointed out that he thinks he has a gas mask filter down there. I'm gonna make a jump for it. Okay, that went well.
Look at that, guys. See that original green color still on it? Wow. You don't find them that often. It must be because it's buried so deep.
It is, right?
Yeah, it's a German gas mask filter. This part contained the carbon, I think, to actually, you know, to clean the air.
There's a marking as well.
Yeah. It's very clear still. Here you can see some of the stuff that already came out. And yeah, we just found this really pretty gas mask filter, German gas mask filter. Writing and color still clearly on there. Green, field army color. We're encountering more and more melted glass. It seems like there has been one big fire here. A lot of stuff that just melted together down there, like glass, coal, some metal parts as well. And you see the side of the stove here, even still has moving parts. The original white enameled color. Look at that. It's gonna be some hard work to get that one out, but we're not giving up. Right, it's really stuck, so we got in some reinforcements. So let's see if we can free this beauty. This is just to show you how difficult it is to dig here. This wall just collapsed on us, and that is like the 30th time that has happened. So yeah, this is quite frustrating. We are almost there. You can really see the contours of the whole thing. We've pulled in it with four grown men, and we're not getting it done without an excavator. And yeah, I think we have to abandon this one. But as you can see, it's a complete field kitchen. These soldiers clearly left this behind, and they burned a lot of stuff. There's a lot of coal as well here in this hole, a lot of melted glass. So we're just gonna detect this area around this dugout and see what we can come up with. Time to close this hole back up. Will take a while, probably. My buddy Ray is testing out his deep seeker. As you can see, it's not really a normal detector. It's really a different sort of ball game. Ray just called me over. He had a very nice signal with his deep seeker right next to this beautiful dugout. And well, we already found some porcelain and some leather parts. Right now, we just found a spoon, and there's way more signals in there. Didn't we just find one of those metal plates on the military boot, Ray? Where is that? Yeah, look at that. That was on the nose of the military boot. Really cool. Well, that's really promising. This is still super shallow and it's packed with signals. So we're gonna see what we can find here. Wow, how many of these plates we got already? Jeez, look at that. Yeah, that's a battery, yep. Carbon battery. These things are British metal toe plates, which were fitted to the leather soles of ammo boots and parade boots. I asked Ray to come and help me out with the signal. I got a huge 80 signal. Alright, so we just pulled this thing out, and I think this is a water tank or a gasoline tank. Also this leather part, piece of a shoe, just dug up, and there is way more in there. So as you can see, the hole has become quite large. We found some more leather parts and just some junk. And then I just hit something massive there. At first I thought it was a bomb or something, but we exposed that a little bit further. And look at that, there's a handle there as well. So we think that this is a German Kochgeschirr, an eating pot, basically standard equipment. Let me just get my other camera. I will get you down there. Right, you see it there? This part here. I think it's actually closed, guys. Okay, Ray, maybe you can help me out to first maybe expose it a little bit further. And then gently, let's see if you can get it out. Maybe it's not a cork shear. Is that standard equipment? There's something inside. Okay guys, I'm not sure if this is actually standard equipment. It's not a cork shear as I thought. But well, definitely has that World War II look. But the most exciting thing, guys, is there is something inside. Oh, look at that. That's original writing right there. You see these letters here, these markings? Wow. Well, I am quite sure this must be something cool, but I've never found this before. So I cannot tell you right away what it is. Let's hope it's a time capsule. What I mean with that is perfectly conserved relics contained in this canister. Let's see if we can open it. Do you hear that? All right guys, it's time to open up this time capsule. We're using a grass knife here very carefully. We've just made a little opening there. And we want to keep this as undamaged as possible, but then again, we must find out what's inside, and probably you guys want to find out too, so Ray is doing a very careful job here. It's almost open there. Careful, putting too much pressure. I think this part here, yeah. Okay, so it's multiple things in there. Piece of cork. Porcelain glass. Why don't we just pour it out, yeah? Alright, we just had a small discussion here, and we think that this is an insulator bottle or canteen or whatever you want to call it, because there is this cork here, there's a rubber seal, there's also rubber down there, that circle. And this was probably on the edge of this thing.
Yeah.
And that's the lid that we just pulled off. We just did a quick Google search and we found it. It's right there. It's a British military thermos flask from the Second World War. And well, I mean, Ray, have you ever seen this?
No, it's my first find.
Yeah, for me as well.
It's the glass part.
Yeah. I've never seen that before. Oh, that was the inside part, the glass part. Wow, British at least. You know these guys love their tea. So I wouldn't be surprised if they actually carried some tea around in this. That is a big surprise. I love surprises. So then that barrel was also British. And maybe there is more in there. Carry on. Very clear, 95 signal. There was something big in there still. Oh, we see something there, guys. And we hear something too. What is that, man? Look at that. Right, it's some sort of tubes down there, and there's some clear color still on there, but what it is, we are not sure. So let's see if we can get this out of the hole. Well, we just pulled those mystery items out of the soil, and
some more.
Ray is telling me that there's more. But yeah, I'm not sure what this is. Look at this. It's some sort of tubes, metal tubes. But you know what's really weird? There's like bandage, like medical bandage is attached to it. Here as well, look at that. But these are just hollow, like sheet metal. Plates rolled up, so I'm not sure what that was exactly, but maybe we'll get more
glass, I think.
Glass?
And bottles.
This dump hole is getting me really excited, guys. More and more surprises by the minute.
Yeah.
Yes?
A bottle.
Okay, wait, let me get down there. I see three bottles
yeah,
at least.
Yeah, three bottles.
Look at that, guys. Okay, I'm gonna get you down there. So this is one bottle. That's the second there. And there is a third there, at least. Oh my God, man. Well, let's try to get them out. Is that a typical British one?
Yeah.
Oh, wait a minute. There is writing there on the side. Is that the Manchester? I think that's the Manchester one, the Palinate.
Mm-hmm.
Does it say Manchester?
Yeah, Manchester.
All right, guys, yes. we know because we found this before. But look how clear that is, guys. Manchester. We're here in Germany on the Western Front. More than 75 years later, finding British World War II stuff. That's a bit where my enthusiasm comes from, guys. I mean, wow. So the other ones are probably also from Manchester. Let's see if we can get those out too.
Yeah, it's the
same one, Manchester. The woods are very peaceful now, as you can see. But these silent reminders are still there. And we're digging them up as we speak. There's more glass there. There we go. Bubble made in England. It's good to be back here at this location and finding similar stuff again as last year when we met up here. Just a short update. More and more bottles, as you can see. We also found part of a military boot, the reinforced sole. And we might have encountered something really amazing right here. We see some fabric.
Ooh.
Wow, what is that? Is that part of a uniform or is that a glove? Or a cap? Look at that. Are there buttons on it or?
I don't feel. No. It's all fabric.
Yeah. Look at that, guys. It's original fabric from the Second World War. Hasn't decayed. That's amazing. It turns out that this is actually a standard issue British Army sock. So the next find to come out is a full sardine can. So we thought it would be funny to maybe open this stuff up. I mean, you don't have to worry about the smell, right? Oh man, this is gonna smell. I wanna see the inside though. Oh my God. Look at that color. Well, maybe they hit some metals in there.
It's empty.
That's too bad. That was fun though. The hole is finally empty. And this is what we dug out there. Many bottles, a lot of them marked. Manchester, for example. We found this very neat British thermos flask. Yeah, really great dump it here. Happy with it. So we're gonna close up the hole now and move on. And just as we were about to close this hole, I was detecting the dugout sound to see if it didn't miss anything. And a very high-pitched signal came through. And it is a jerry can cap, basically a screw cap. But look at this. There is still paper on it. And what does it say? It says, England. That's very neat. I'm really gonna do my best to save that. It's a great piece for display. And that is that, nice and level again. So I think we're gonna detect this area a little bit more. But unfortunately, our time ran out, so we're gonna pack our stuff and we'll be leaving this forest. Before I close off entirely, I wanna say a special thank you to all of my patrons who helped to support the channel. If you want to get access to some exclusive content, go and check out my Patreon. That is it from our side, the day is over, we're gonna go home.
Don't forget to check out World of Tanks and make sure to use the link in the description.
See you guys next time, cheers.